Hey YouTube, Jim here. Welcome to Top 10 Archive. Now everybody's heard of the great white shark, and movies like Jaws have made them synonymous with sharp teeth and deadly attacks. But what you might not know is that there are over 440 other breeds of shark out there in our oceans right now that we know of. While some are portrayed as big, brutal killers, just like our good friend the great white, others are known for a quiet life of lazing on the seabed. We've rounded up 10 of the most amazing sharks that have ever lived, and that you've probably never heard of. And before we get started, help us out by hitting that like button and be sure to leave us a comment because we're always looking to engage in interesting conversations with you. Also, don't forget to click the bell so you get notified every time we put out a new video. Number 10, basking shark. Known for loafing in the sun near the surface of the water, these gentle giants don't hunt. They simply filter plankton from the water with their gills. With 8,000 pounds or 3,600 kilograms of bulk to drag around, it's no wonder they don't move about much. They're the second largest shark after the whale shark, as these mighty baskers can grow up to 30 feet or 9 meters in length. Number 9, cookie cutter shark. Don't be fooled, this cute sounding creature isn't as innocent as you might think. The adorable name of this 2-foot or 50-centimeter long shark has been earned through the large scars they leave behind on their victims after an attack. Living at depths of roughly 2 miles, attacks on humans are rare and generally happen upon fishermen removing them from fishing nets, using its jaws to literally bite chunks out of victims. If you happen across dead oceanic life with a gaping hole in them, there's a good chance they fell victim to a cookie cutter shark. Number 8, goblin shark. The goblin shark, which resides throughout the world at depths of 100 meters or about 330 feet, is an incredibly rare and equally strange-looking breed. Equipped with an extendable jaw that can grab its prey much like a hand and the ability to sense the electric field of other living things around it, you'd better give it a wide berth if you happen to encounter this monster. Until it was found off the coast of Japan in 1898, it was presumed extinct for 100 million years, and most of what we know about this ancient monster is from chance encounters by a lucky few. Number 7, Ninja Lantern Shark. Whoa! Sorry. Though we've covered this unique shark in a prior video, it still remains widely unrecognized. Discovered in 2010 off the Pacific coast of Central America, this jet-black deep-sea dweller has light-emitting photophores, which are used as camouflage and to attract prey. Researchers named this newly discovered species Epmopterus benchleyi, after Peter Benchley, the author of Jaws and a passionate shark advocate. But its common name, Ninja Lantern Shark, was chosen by the young cousins of Vicky Vasquez, a member of the team that identified the shark. The kids originally wanted to go with Super Ninja, and personally we think that would have been an equally good choice. Number 6, Megamouth Shark. The award for the most literal name definitely goes to the Megamouth Shark. So rare is this particular breed, it wasn't even discovered until 1976, and only a few of them have been seen since then. 61 as of April 2015 to be exact. Unsurprisingly, the megamouth can be recognized by its, well, megamouth. Their giant gob is constantly open, ready to scoop up plankton, and although it has 50 rows of tiny hooked teeth, they're hardly ever used for hunting. Number 5, angel shark. You'd be forgiven for mistaking the angel shark for a stingray because of their large fins, flat bodies, and bottom-feeding nature. The telltale difference, though, is that with the shark, the pectoral fins aren't attached to the head. Angel sharks tend to skulk about buried in mud with only their eyes visible, a method of camouflage that makes them great at ambushing their victims. Because of this intricate method of camouflage, you probably wouldn't notice when you were near one until it's too late. Number 4, Wobbegong Shark. Despite an average length of 8 feet or 2.5 meters, this shark is as harmless as it sounds. Found mostly around Australia and the West Pacific Ocean, this lazy bottom feeder spends most of its time on the ocean floor waiting for fish to come near. When fish do come near, the wobbegong filters them into its mouth with sensory barbs or distinctive worm-like flaps of skin hanging from their head. These flaps of skin are where the wobbegong gets its fancy name from, as is believed that the word derives from an Australian Aboriginal word for shaggy beard. Number 3. Spiny dogfish shark. If you ever bump into a shark, you're most likely to bump into this one. The most abundant shark in the world, they can mainly be found in a variety of habitats, including estuaries. The spiny dogfish are seen to be a nuisance by fishermen as they've been known to damage fishing gear and are often considered a bycatch. Depending on who you listen to, the spiny dogfish is either venomous, poisonous, or carries an infectious bacteria on its spikes. Either way though, the prickly predator may look and sound frightening, but it's practically harmless to humans. Number 2. Thresher shark. This swift-moving fish stands out from the other breeds on our list thanks to its incredible tail, which makes up around a third of its entire body weight and is usually as long as the shark itself, too. Their tail isn't just for show, either. This very intelligent species uses it to herd small fish like cattle, making for an easy meal. Attacks on humans by threshers are pretty much unheard of, but instead, it's us that are a threat in this relationship. Fishermen catch them for sport, and their fins, liver oil, tails, and flesh are all valuable commodities in certain parts of the world. Number 1. Orthacanthus. This primitive monster from 300 million years ago was known to grow up to 10 feet or 3 meters long. It was one of the top ocean predators of their time. But what makes this prehistoric shark stand out is that it ate the young from its own breed. Yeah, that's right. They were shark cannibals. Thought to be similar to today's bull shark, the Orthacanthus migrated between swamps, estuaries, and seas. It's thought that they practiced filial cannibalism, which means that they only ate their young when no other food could be found in their environment. So that makes it a little less horrifying, right?